patients with acute liver failure initially present with severe hepatitis.
So concerns that the influenza vaccine is not safe. It's not safe for them, exactly. It's not safe in general. What do you comment about this?
In the past, we used to get some problems with the vaccination. Today, the vaccine has no mercury, no thiomersal, the adjuvant is very safe. It gives us or boosts our
stewardship in the local community practice. Thank you.
So, non-communicable diseases are an old problem, and there are many well-known old solutions.
Unfortunately, this controversy has arisen.
What is the role of screening? Screening is...
So, there's a knowledge gap, and there's no real consensus about the long-term safety and benefits.
Best possible treatment for patients. But best possible treatment does not only involve best treatment for the aspect.
Bariatric surgery is weight loss surgery. Surgery to help patients manage their weight has now become a risk to health and not just an anesthetic.
Sitting in front or behind the hilum can manifest itself
with transarterial hemoembolization, which is commonly abbreviated as TACE, and we only treat certain types of tumors following discussion at the multidisciplinary locally. So we're giving a small dose of chemotherapy into a small volume, making it a relatively high dose, okay? Just locally. Yeah.
Calcium scores don't involve contrast, so we don't need to cannulate the patients, we don't need to screen them for contraindications to IV contrast, and it's an even faster and simpler test. I'll go ahead.
Diagnosing hypertension properly, you need time, you need patience, and you need some dedication.
Not really sure if beta blockers, the modern beta blockers, the third generation beta blockers like
particularly in the era of exercise-related deaths pertaining to athletes.
Time there was refinement into even modern medicines. We have also seen that some of the modern medicines are actually derived from these medicinal products.
So to understand how cannabis works on the brain, we need to understand that we have what is known as an endocannabinoid system.
As medical students, we're all invited to present our cases, and then as junior doctors, you know, it increases in complexity. So that's probably the first encounter with a research project, and the presentation is more difficult. There's also another problem, I think another difficulty, is how to condense your research.
What we normally do is we select a sample, okay, which is a subset of the population, and then from the sample we try to make inference about the population.
Learn skills of paper writing easily. So there are many skills involved, so finding material to publish, gathering data, dealing with ethics, data protection, data analysis, data presentation at conference.
And biofreezing has traditionally been done in countries where it's allowed via a process called slow cryopreservation, so slow freezing. But embryo vitrification is slowly being the method and the way forward.
Look at a population study as against individual patients, where you have clear identification of risk factors and fracture risk. I think that the data are stronger. When you do a meta-analysis and you pull up studies where there are patients who have low perspective, there's a lot of fear of a very unlikely event.
If you do not have access to natriuretic peptides, then an echocardiogram is a very important first-line investigation.
So there are two guidelines, the European Society of Cardiology guidelines and the American Heart Association. It was switched to an ARNI and it was started on sacubitril valsartan, and this was up-titrated to the maximum tolerated
dose. The paradigm study, which is a major multi-center international study, which has shown that patients treated with entresto have been shown to have a reduction of about 20% hospitalizations
performance, because there is good evidence that improvement in cardiac function can produce increases in
regular irregular. His heart sounds, the head, and an S1.
Foremost, give a lot of education. Mainly, the patients need to monitor their daily, restrict the fluid intake to 1.5 liters of fluid daily.